Hi, I'm JayDee Gunnell.
And I'm Jerry Goodspeed. We're two of the garden experts here at Utah State University Botanical Center in Kaysville, Utah. Today we're going to talk a little bit about iron deficiency in plants.
Now, iron deficiencies are very common in the Intermountain West. It's not because we lack iron in our soils, but it's because it's tied very tightly to the soil particle itself.
And you can always see the symptom of iron chlorosis, because what it'll do is the veins in the leaves will remain green, but the interveinal area, that area between the veins, turns yellow. And sometimes it'll even get so severe that you have smaller leaves, they'll be brown, they'll even burn, and it'll restrict growth so that it's not as good as you'd like it to be.
And certain plants are more susceptible to this nutrient deficiency. Plants such as silver maples, quaking aspen, peaches, grapes. These are all plants that have a little bit of problem with obtaining that iron from the soils.
So the real question then becomes, okay, how do I control it? I mean, I see it out there. Well, obviously some of the best idea is just to grow the right plant. Don't grow plants that are sensitive or susceptible to iron chlorosis. A couple of other things to keep in mind is don't overwater. Heavy soils restrict that water or that iron uptake. And also, select a site that has good drainage. And sometimes you have to create that drainage, but the better you can create it or have a site that drains well, the plants are gonna do better.
Now, if you do have a plant that has iron deficiency, there are many products out there that you can utilize. There's foliar sprays, soil treatments, but the one that works probably the best for homeowners is called a chelated iron. Chelated just means that it's packaged in a way that the soil can't bind to it before the plants get it.
We like the chelated iron. You mix it with water and you apply it. And we're going to show you how to do that right now. What we will normally do is we'll just take a 5-gallon bucket. We'll put in here, we've got a gallon of water in here. We'll read the instructions, make sure that we're applying it properly and following the instructions. Ours says to put a teaspoon of the product into a gallon of water. And fortunately for us, they even gave us with a little teaspoon. So we'll take that teaspoon, we'll pour it in. JayDee will mix that up for us.
You gotta be careful because this stuff stains.
Bad. And everything. Once we've got it mixed up, we're simply gonna take it and pour it around the root zone of our plant.
Now the timing on this is usually early spring before the plant leaves out. Iron is taken up in the early spring. For more information on iron deficiency and susceptible plants, check out our website at garden.usu.edu.